But Wave Walker rode out the storm, and by the morning of January 6, with the wind easing, I tried to get a reading on the sextant. Sextant is an instrument with the graduated arc of 60 degrees for taking altitudes and navigation. Okay, so he says, I tried to get a reading on the sextant. Back in the chart room, I worked on wind speeds also, changes of course and drift and current in an effort to calculate our position. So he started reading all these things and checking to get the position, to calculate the position. The best I could determine was that we were somewhere in 150,000 kilometers of ocean looking for a 65 kilometer wide island. While I was thinking, Sue, moving painfully, joined me. The left side of her head was now very swollen and her blackened eyes narrowed to slits. So while the narrator was still thinking, his daughter Sue joined him and she was in pain. The left side of her head was swollen and her blackened eyes had narrowed down to slits, to cut. And she gave me a card she had made. So Sue had made one card and that card she gave to father, to the narrator. On the front, she had drawn caricatures of Mary and me with the words, "Here are some funny people. Did they make you laugh?" I laughed a lot as well. Inside was a message, "Oh, how I love you both. So this card is to say thank you and let's hope for the best." Somehow we had to make it. So the card which she gave to father, on the front of the card was a cartoon image of her parents with the words written about them being funny people and how they made them laugh. Inside of the card, there was written, she told them how she loved them both and she thanked them for being best parents. This made the narrator realize that they had to make it to the island. I checked and rechecked my calculations. We had lost our main compass and I was using a spare which had not been corrected for magnetic variation. I made an allowance for this and another estimate of the influence of the westerly currents which flow through this part of the Indian Ocean. Though he was without equipments, still he rechecked the calculations as main compass was not with them and they were using the spare one which was not corrected for magnetic variations. So he estimated the influence of the westerly currents which flow through the Indian Ocean, and then around 2 p.m. I went on deck and asked Larry to steer a course of 185 degrees. If we were lucky, I told him with a conviction, I did not feel he could expect to see the island at about 5 p.m. So after making all these calculations, he was thinking that he was going to get the island. So he felt if they were lucky, they would see the island by 5 p.m. Then with a heavy heart, I went below, climbed on my bunk. Bunk is kind of sleeping place, bed kind of thing. I climbed on my bunk and amazingly dozed off. Amazingly, he's using amazingly because in that tough time also, he could sleep. But as he was too tired, and that was the best thing which they could do. When I woke up, it was 6 p.m. And what time he gave? 5 p.m. But now he woke up at 6 p.m. And growing dark, I knew we must have missed the island. He was thinking, he was not having any optimistic thing. Because he was very practical at that point, that without the equipments and all, it was getting very difficult to get the exact idea. But at 6 p.m. when he woke up, he says, I knew we must have missed the island and with the sail we had left. We couldn't hope to beat back into the westerly winds. At that moment, a tousled head appeared by my bunk. Tousled? Messy head. So, messy head. And that messy head was his son, Jonathan. He says, Jonathan, and there was Sue also right behind him. And the son says, can I have a hug? So narrator asks, Why am I getting a hug now? He says, son replied, because you are the best daddy in the whole world and the best captain also. Father said, not today, John. I'm afraid that I'm the best daddy or best captain, because he was thinking that he missed the chance to get island and he missed the chance to save his family. So then Sue said in a matter-of-fact voice, why? You must be. You are the best captain because you found the island. Then the narrator, he shouted, what? It's out there in front of us. They chorus. So chorus means saying together. So both the children, they shouted together, it's out. It's that island is out front of us and it's as big as a battleship. I rushed on deck and gazed with relief at the stark outline of Île Amsterdam. It was only a bleak piece of volcanic rock with little vegetation. So how's that island? It's very small and have only a bleak piece of volcanic rock and very little vegetation. Still, the narrator says that the island was the most beautiful island in the world, because that island was their hope. That island was which saved them. We anchored offshore for the night, and the next morning all 28 inhabitants of the island cheered as they helped us ashore. So they anchored, they moored, they fastened to that island, the ship at some distance. So offshore means at some distance, near the shore but at some distance. And the next morning 28 inhabitants, so on that island there were only 28 inhabitants, so all 28 inhabitants, those who stayed there, they saved them. So they helped them to move on the shore of the land. With land under my feet again, my thoughts were full of Larry and Irvi, those crewmen. Cheerful, optimistic under the direst stress. These two crewmen, they were cheerful and optimistic under the direst stress. Such a bad stress also, these two guys were working hard with a positive attitude. And then he was thinking about his wife Mary, who stayed at the wheel for all those crucial hours. So all these significant hours, more than 32, when they were just trying to find island and to save themselves. In that whole period, his wife Mary was at that steering wheel only. And most of all, he says, I thought of a 7-year-old girl who did not want us to worry about a head injury, which subsequently took 6 major operations to remove a recurring blood clot between skin and skull. So this injury was not an ordinary injury. Subsequently, later on, this injury took 6 minor operations to remove the recurring blood clot between skin and skull. And of a 6-year-old boy who was not afraid to die, who was giving hope to his father that if we all are together, there is no fear of being dead also.